I'm very pleased to introduce our guest speaker, Stella Ursua of the North American Association of Green Technology. She has an extensive background in green industries and has graciously volunteered to present today's session. Please join us in welcoming her to LBCC.
Thanks, Debbie. Thanks, Long Beach City College and the cameramen that are filming this for us. And thanks to all of you for joining us today. As Debbie mentioned, this is a program on green collar jobs, okay? And if I get away from the mic a little too far, please let me know, because I have a habit of walking around, so my apologies right up front. So the name of this workshop is called, What the Heck is a Green Collar Job? Preparing for Green Career Opportunities. And the reason I called it that is because we used to go to job fairs and career fairs and such, and people would ask, well, what the heck is a green collar job? So I figured, you know what, maybe we get a little attention with the name of that, the name of the program like this. And so sure enough, Debbie heard about us and she gave me a call and said, hey, could you come and do this workshop for us? We're really interested in learning more about green careers. And so that's what it's all about. Okay, I'm gonna fly through this fairly quickly. Please, stop me if you guys have any questions. We have a couple of hours. We'll probably finish before then. We'll probably take a break as well. And so I want this to be an interactive type of session. If you have questions, please don't hesitate to ask. Let me warn you though, I know this much about green jobs, okay, and green industries, but I've been researching now for the past several years and trying to learn basically as much as I can about these types of jobs and these types of training programs and how to get into these jobs so that it helps us to train individuals that eventually come to our school, okay? But also, like Long Beach City College, Cal State Long Beach, some of the other schools around here, they're offering similar types of programs. And my belief is the more that we educate the masses out there about green jobs, the more people that we will have interested in joining these types of professions. So with that, let me get started here. My name's Stella Ursua, president of a couple of companies, Stella Organizational Development and the North American School of Green Technology. We're gonna be launching that school in the next couple of months over on Long Beach Boulevard. I'm also the education coordinator for Green Long Beach. And if you haven't had a chance to pick up a little poster there, we're having a festival on June 11th over at the Promenade. It's the third annual Green Long Beach Festival. And so we have entertainers and educational workshops. We have exhibitors and vendors and all sorts of things planned for the day. So please join us, okay? I'm also a concerned citizen, and that's why I'm doing this. I was telling Debbie and Jerome, one of the camera guys, I don't get paid for doing this. It's just, we are so passionate about this. We want more people to join us and to start to work at these various industries, okay? Also, my partner, Marcia Tolentino, she's the vice president of the school. Say hi, Marcia. She's also a concerned citizen. And so she'll be helping me as well. She will be taking pictures as well, so hopefully you don't mind. Together, we formed the school, a woman-owned, minority-owned business. So we're really excited about that. We have careers in minus training and education. Marcia's marketing and sales. And so, we're just really passionate about this particular field. And so that's why we're doing this. So we're affiliated with all of these, various organizations here. If you want information on any of these organizations, please come up to me after the workshop and I can give you more information on affiliations like the U.S. Green Building Council, American Solar Energy Society, the California Green Workforce Coalition, Repower LA, Inland Empire Veterans Employment Coalition, and Green Long Beach, and Rebuild United States. So those are just some of the organizations that we belong to. Okay. So what was the first green job? Let me ask anybody. Just thinking back historically. Oops, too fast, sorry. First green job in your mind. Yes, sir.
Windmills.
What's that?
Windmills.
Oh, good answer. Absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. Why do you say windmills?
Because they've been around for a long time.
Been around for a long time, and what do windmills do?
They grind corn and wheat.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. And they help to water. Yeah. Exactly. Exactly. That's a good answer. Anyone else? Well, if we go back to historic times, there were green farmers back there, I'm sure, right? They were finding ways to grow various crops and to figure out, you know, how to grow for the coming seasons and how to recycle and reuse and, right? So, I mean, they've been around forever, these green jobs. We just didn't think of them as green jobs back then, right? So in your opinion, though, what is a green job? Anyone? Renewable energy. Okay. Anything in renewable energy? Anyone else? Yes. Yes, ma'am. Okay. So a job that treats the environment in a way that doesn't leave a detrimental impact on the environment. Good answer. Excellent. I couldn't have done any better. That's what we're going to find out today. Okay. There are all sorts of opinions out there about what a green job is. Right? I'm going to give you a look at the various industries that are considered green. All right. So any of you currently working in a green job right now? No hands? Well, tell you what, I bet you in the next 3 to 5 years, majority of you will be in green jobs. And I'm really excited about that because we see more and more movement towards organizations becoming more sustainable. So even an accountant, an HR rep, an IT person, all of those individuals and these organizations are going to be challenged to become more green, more sustainable. And you will have a green job, I promise you. Okay? So with that, here's 3 goals for today. Better define green jobs, green collar jobs specifically. Identify how to prepare for those green jobs. And identify creative methods for finding employment. Okay, and we've got a bunch of other things in this workshop as well that I think that you will benefit from. So what is a green collar job? Here's one definition. Anyone recognize this gentleman here? Van Jones. He was the founder of Green for All. And he was the former special green jobs advisor to the White House. President Obama has really been a huge proponent of green jobs. You heard him talking about it when he was on the campaign, and he's been doing things, you know, since he was elected to create more green jobs and a sustainable and green economy. So this is the gentleman that helped him start this whole effort. But his definition is a green collar job is a blue collar job upgraded to better respect the environment. Very similar to what you said. What was your name? Lisa? Ladine, sorry. You were right on the money there. Here's another one though. Green jobs produce supply goods or services that result in generating and storing renewable energy, recycling existing materials, energy efficient product manufacturing, distribution, construction, installation and maintenance, education, compliance and awareness, and natural and sustainable product manufacturing. So that's a more extensive definition, and this was from, what is that? I'm sorry, can't read that from here. Labor market information from the Green Digest. So you could look up the definition of green jobs. Do a Google search and you'll probably find 100 different definitions. Those are just a couple that I liked. Here's one more. I'm not going to read through this, but it sounds pretty similar. This is from the Secretary of the Department of Environmental Protection, and she talks about what a green job means to her. Okay? So pretty similar, though. What's the difference, though, with a green-collar job, right? You know, compared to a blue-collar, white-collar job? Well, many of these positions do not actually require a college or graduate degree. So you could potentially attend a technical skills training program, get a certificate, and you know be at a green company's doorstep, you know, after you get done with that program. So that's the difference. And there's a real sense of urgency right now in finding individuals with these certificates and with these skills. Every day, Marcia and I are at some sort of a workshop or a conference or some sort of a meeting, and there are people standing here where I'm standing, and they're talking about, we don't have enough workers. We don't have enough people trained for these jobs. And all we hear about out here is, you know, the unemployment rates, right? Yeah. I'm telling you, these folks are desperate to try and find employees for their businesses. So that's the good news right there. According to the Council of Economic Advisors, green jobs pay an average of 10 to 20% more than other jobs. So that's also some good news. So green collar jobs, American Solar Energy Society says that currently there are 9 million green collar jobs and 1.4 billion in revenue in U.S. renewable energy and energy efficient industries. These are just a few of those industries there. We've got your wind turbine, your wind energy organizations, solar energy, green buildings, and alternative fuels, and now the smart meters that are going to be required to charge up all of these electric vehicles. Anyone drive a hybrid out there or an electric vehicle yet? Yay. Excellent. Thank you. Yeah, I mean, all of the car companies now are trying to figure out, okay, how do we get the electric cars out there now? But also, do we have enough charging stations to get these electric cars running and to make sure that they have enough power to get, you know, from point A to point B, right? So more jobs. Just, you know, a little more information there about the amount of money that is going to be required to keep this whole movement going. And so we're talking about here $500 billion. If we invest that much over the next 10 years, we could potentially create 5 million high-quality, green-quality jobs. So why do you think there's a sudden interest in green energy and green jobs? Any thoughts? Yes, sir.
What got me interested in what's going on in Japan, the nuclear issues, yes. And in the Middle East, oil is going crazy.
Absolutely.
In the future, come on, can we make change?
Absolutely.
For the environment and for employment.
Right on, right on. Yes, ma'am. Okay. Okay. Good, excellent. Yes, ma'am.
A lot of people are in denial about the impact of greenhouse gases and the ozone depletion, and now maybe seeing more about like polar bear,
mm-hmm.
things like that, and
the extinction. Exactly. Yeah, yeah, absolutely. If you have a chance to see this film, it's called Climate Refugees. Anyone seen that yet? No? Excellent movie, and it talks about what you're describing. You know, our climate has changed over, you know, the past few centuries, right? And it shows specifically how, you know, through climate change, individuals from these various countries and here in the U.S. as well are now becoming refugees of climate situations. Think about Katrina, right? Where did all those people end up? They're not still in New Orleans along the Gulf Coast. They've moved now to other parts of the U.S. What was it? The tsunami, the whole thing that happened in Japan. Yeah, where are those people going, right? I mean, it seems like every month something is happening on a global scale as far as some sort of climate situation or a climate tragedy, right? So most definitely that is why there's a sudden interest, right? Along with running out of fossil fuels, you guys, you mentioned that, Gulf Wars for oil, the BP Gulf oil spill, right? Everyone remember that? That was just last year, wasn't it? Today? Yeah, exactly. It's kind of ironic that we're doing this presentation today. The depletion of our natural resources, pollution of our land, air, water sources, health reasons, global economic recession, right? All of those things. Let me just take a step back there. All of those reasons why there's this emphasis now and this sense of urgency for more sustainable type of living, more renewable energy, more and thus more green jobs. Right? So, but it's not anything new. These things were being looked at by various individuals, like for example, Rachel Carson, who was one of the founders of the whole environmental movement back in the 60s. And you might find some of these books here of interest, Silent Spring and The Sea Around Us. And so she was a marine biologist and nature writer who started to study what was happening to our environment. And then you started to see the environmental sciences programs that started to become more popular, right? So, you know, during the late 60s, 70s, that's when this started to take off. Now what's happening with the investment in green jobs, the private sector, they're investing billions of dollars. And I think this is important to note that since 2007, $1.6 trillion have been invested in those technologies there. Renewable energy, efficiency, green construction, clean tech industries, smart grid, and corporate research and development. What does that mean? Jobs. Jobs for those that are willing to put the effort behind, you know, the education, the certificates, the accreditation, and building those skills that are required for those jobs. So big chunks of money that are being invested here. And we happen to live in the most innovative state, California. So we've invested $11.6 billion in clean tech investments. Yes. Sorry about that. Can you hear me? Okay. Sorry about that. Okay. So we've done some major investment in clean tech industries here in California. We lead the nation in renewable energy like solar and wind, electric cars, hybrid vehicles, green construction. So you live in a great place. It may not feel like that all the time, but we live in a very innovative state. My friends from Hawaii say your own country. California is your own country, right? So why is this important? Well, you know, we're looking at record unemployment rates, right? Long Beach, 13.9%. Inland Empire, 15%. LA County, what is that, 12.4%? So the new green collar economy could restore a rapidly disintegrating middle class. That's why this is important to all of us. So the federal government is investing billions of dollars. As I mentioned, Obama is really putting his money where his mouth is. He was just on doing a presentation, I think it was last week or the week before, talking about how much more he wants to invest in green jobs. So the money is there. Now it's, you know, the rest of Congress might not like that, and the oil companies and, you know, some of the folks that have, you know, their interests there that are being challenged by clean energy, but there are major investments being made in a green economy. And so here's just a few more here. He challenged each department, each of the, you know, like Department of Labor, Department of Energy, Transportation, the Veterans Administration, and he's asking all of these departments, you need to do things more sustainably. You need to start to save energy, right? You need to create an environment where all of your employees are completely clear as to how to save energy, to become more sustainable, and to save us money. Because, you know, the government's broke, basically, right? So this is how we're going to make back some of that money. There's an executive order that went out to all the different departments. I'll just point out one thing here. You know, the Veterans Administration really leads the country in sustainability and energy efficiency. They are doing some amazing things to their buildings. right? Putting solar on all their hospitals. They're you know, going paperless and trying to create a more efficient process throughout their hospitals and their offices. Over in their cemeteries, for example, they're starting to create native landscaping and energy efficient irrigation systems so that they save more water. They're saving millions and millions of dollars by doing this. So, and they started this even before Obama started to challenge the different organizations and departments. So that's really neat to see around the globe. A growing population with a higher ambition for living standards, which inevitably leads to a world which will be resource and carbon constrained. So it's not just here in the United States, obviously. There are some countries like Germany and Japan until recently that, you know, started to take the lead as far as renewable energy. A lot of things going on throughout the globe. And I can show you job boards with just pages and pages of jobs for, you know, Great Britain and other parts of Europe, where they're looking for folks to, you know, become sustainability advisors and engineers, and I mean all these different positions is really amazing to see. Let's see, I'm gonna kind of skim through a couple of these slides here. World Wildlife Federation reports that at least 3.4 million European jobs directly related to renewable energy. So the green economy is starting to take place. In India alone, headhunters estimate that there are going to be about 1 million green jobs that will open up over the next 2 years alone. Places like China and India, They're manufacturing these components for us because, you know, all of this is currently being outsourced to these countries. We'd like to turn that around. We'd like to bring some of those jobs back here to the U.S. obviously. So, but this is what's happening around the globe. So we've already talked about green jobs and what they're typically associated with, right? Alternative fuels and vehicles. Let's take a little bit closer look here. Anyone interested in biofuels? What is a biofuel? Anyone? Any thoughts, sir? Yes. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So it's growing rapidly. It's to meet the demand for clean, renewable, and domestic energy. And we're looking for skilled biofuels engineers and technicians and scientists. Very high demand industry right now, biofuels, right? So these are some of the positions that are related to the biofuels industry and some of the schools that are offering programs in biofuels. These are some of the average salaries for these positions, which is pretty impressive. This one, I think it's what, 109,000? Yeah, so pretty impressive. If you have, you know, the time to take a four-year degree program. Here's some of the companies that are working on biofuels right now. More companies. Didn't realize how many companies are out there, right? And this is really interesting. In Southern California, there are approximately, let me take a look here real quick. Yes, 11 centers and 8 companies, thank you. I need to put my glasses on. Just in Southern California, in the San Diego area. I never knew this. So this is, again, huge industry that's growing every day, leaps and bounds, right? So if you're interested in biofuels or learning about biofuels, definitely there's lots of positions that are open right now. And it's a growing field. They have staffing firms specific to biofuels. Right? They can't find people fast enough. Alternative fuel vehicles. I understand that Long Beach City College has an LNG program here, right? Liquid natural gas vehicles program. So this is going to continue to increase in demand. Hybrid, electric, LNG, CNG, biodiesel, hydrogen vehicles. all the car companies are trying to develop these types of vehicles, right? So what's a hybrid vehicle company out there right now? Toyota, how about Toyota, right? That's a well-known company, right? Well, they're looking at electric vehicles. They're looking at hydrogen vehicles, right? BMW has got a hydrogen car. Who was it? Porsche is coming out with an electric vehicle. Very expensive, but you know they're coming out with one. So now there's going to be this competition, I imagine, to get their cars out, you know, in the next few years. So 2012, 2013, you'll see just a huge, chain of events that happen where more of these car companies are going to be putting out electric and hybrid vehicle cars. So really exciting to see who's going to be working on these vehicles, who's going to be manufacturing them, right? Hopefully some of you, hopefully, you know, some of your friends and family. In California, we're driving the change here. 24% of alternative fuel vehicles are registered here in California. Again, we lead the way. Types of positions, the alternative fuel vehicle technician, the EV charging technician, smart grid service technician, vehicle conversion specialist, that's going to be a big one right there. Anyone that likes working on cars, there's gosh, Marcia, help me out here. We were just at a workshop. Oh, I know. It was over in the Inland Empire. There's a gentleman there who started his own company, and that's what his business is going to be, is to convert our cars into electric and hybrid vehicles. Big money. Big money. And he's going to be looking for folks to help him do that. Battery recycling technicians. So a lot of various positions that are going to be tied to alternative fuel vehicles. Renewable energy, you know, these are the ones that we typically think of, right? Wind, solar energy, but there's also geothermal, biofuels, and so some of the positions that are tied to these industries, wind turbine machinists, solar and PV installers, iron and steel workers, solar operations engineers, and a host of other jobs that are tied to these industries. If you look at this picture right here, again, immediately you think of a solar installer, right? That's what I think of. But who else might be tied to this? What other type of workers are we going to need on these types of projects? And these are huge solar farms that are being built all over California, all over the US. I'm sorry, say that?
Architects,
okay.
Electricians,
absolutely. Absolutely. What else?
Sales and marketing.
Most definitely. Every solar company that we talk to, they need sales and marketing representatives.
Meteorologists.
What's that?
Meteorologists.
Absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. So again, it's not just the solar installer or the electrician. There are so many other jobs that are tied to these types of projects, right? And again, hopefully this is something that you might see yourself in, or family members. Maybe some of you have kids, right? That's something that Marcia and I are trying to work on right now, is get into the high schools, even elementary schools. And we have some of this going on already, but really to create some sort of a curriculum for them so that they learn more about these types of positions, because we really believe that this is our future right here. The solar energy, as far as where all the development is right now, the market, again, California leads the way. We accounted for 53% of all installations, and we will maintain a strong position. Actually, that should say 2011. My apologies there. We're still leading the way. If you look at a list of all the states around the country that are installing solar, we have surpassed all the other states, you know, like threefold, right? So there's a lot of activity going on here. More jobs projected. We're talking about, this is a little bit old here, but you know, over 17,000 jobs being added to the U.S. economy here. Okay, 60,000 by the end of 2010. So, you know, a big, big, big field right here. So, you know, if this is your interest, where do you fit in? This is what I say to all the kids that come to these workshops, right? You know, again, it's not just about a solar installation job. It could be a system designer. It could be an estimator. It could become a sales or service representative. We need all of these individuals prepared for these jobs here. Green building. Anyone familiar with the United States Green Building Council? Anyone heard that? Yeah. Excellent. So green building or sustainable building, basically it's about creating and using healthier and more resource efficient models of construction, renovation, operation, maintenance, and demolition. And this is a huge, huge industry here in the U.S. Green building has the potential to add up to $554 billion to the U.S. GDP and to save or create 7.9 million jobs. Talks a little bit about wages there. Leadership in energy and environmental design, this is one of those hot certificates that's out there right now. The abbreviation is LEED, but basically it's an internationally recognized green building certification system. And it's about designing and using strategies aimed at performing across all metrics. So you're trying to save energy, you're trying to save water, CO2 emission reduction, improved indoor environmental quality, and stewardship of resources and sensitivity to their impacts. So for each of those areas there are jobs specific to saving energy, to creating water efficient systems in a building, to reducing CO2 emissions. There are tons of jobs tied to green building. Some of those are a commissioning agent, project managers, green facility manager, green architects, energy engineers, and senior design engineers. In one of the slides, I think I moved a little too quick there, but California just recently certified the 10,000th green home or LEED certified home. That's huge because this whole LEED type of process was more specific to green buildings or to making buildings more energy efficient, and now it's moving into people actually wanting their homes to be LEED certified. So that's a huge step right there. Now they're moving into healthcare and going into hospitals to trying to determine, okay, how can we make this building more energy efficient? How can we create more sustainable practices? And so all of those job titles there, those are the folks that they're gonna need to be working in those hospitals. Those are the folks that they'll need to be certifying homes and buildings and checking them every year to make sure that they're still energy efficient. So this is a really neat place to be at right now. Anyone thought about green building as a profession? Excellent. Talk to me after the workshop, okay? Yeah, that's great. We were just at a conference last week. There were 700 individuals tied to green building at this workshop. And it was just, you know, a workshop here over in Rosemead. They have it every year though. And from what I understand, just within the last 10 years or so, I mean, it's tripled. The amount of people that are now attending these workshops, because there's all of a sudden there's this interest. It's like, hey, you know what? This is a fantastic field to be in. And you know, why not get my foot in the door too? So now you have electricians and contractors, construction workers, all these folks that, you know, they had this path, you know, as a career, and now they're seeing, you know what, I'm gonna look over on this side too, because there's a bunch of opportunities to take advantage of. So also energy efficient auditing and retrofitting, this is another big area right here. There's an organization called Energy Upgrade California that has a, you know what, Marcia, would you help me with this? Because you're the expert on this area here.
Energy Upgrade California.
Speak louder, please.
Thank you.
Energy Upgrade California is, it's an organization that's working directly with the local utility companies to try and encourage homeowners to do more retrofitting into their homes so that they will then become more energy efficient. And they are offering anywhere from $1,000 up to $4,500 to homeowners that are that would wanna, you know, retrofit their homes. And why is this happening? It's because the government, the utility companies, is trying to push the economy to create more jobs.
And she's passionate about this particular area here. We're actually working with a contractor that basically we're trying to educate folks out there, homeowners, that you know might consider doing this type of work to their home. And you know, bottom line, it's a win-win. They save money, they save energy, and we create jobs. So you know, we want to be able to train people for these jobs and then create a situation where there's an actual general contractor that will take on these individuals, you know, and employ them to conduct some of these retrofits and auditing of homes. So really exciting for us. But this is a huge area of opportunity right now. And basically it's, you know, about repairing buildings so that they lose less energy, right? Energy auditors, green carpenters, insulation installers, HVAC technicians. So consider that, let's say you're an HVAC technician, air conditioning, right? There's some new things that you have to learn about creating a more sustainable and energy efficient home. It's not doing business, you know, like you did before. There's some new techniques, some new rules that you have to follow. So, you know, more opportunities though. And there's expected to be 20% growth in energy efficiency and retrofitting and auditing. So a huge area of opportunity. Green building, more green building and related professions. This is another big one, and this is one of the hot certifications, building performance analyst. Okay, so these are the individuals, like Marcia was just describing, that get the jobs to go into companies and homes and determine where they're losing energy, right? So another big certification here. Yes, ma'am.
The BPI certification, U.S. Energy Upgrade California is actually working hand in hand with Long Beach City College. They're offering, they're going to be offering scholarships for contractors that that will take that certification, and that's a very expensive certification. So if you know any contractors that would like to get into this industry, talk with Debbie to, you know, with Rola to get more information as far as the scholarship is concerned. Okay.
Thank you. Yeah, you know, that's really important because this organization, again, they're working closely with Southern California Edison, Department of Energy. They couldn't find any contractors. They couldn't find any contractors to go through this training to learn these new techniques. You know, and how many of you guys know a contractor out there, right? I think we all have one in our family or a friend, right? So it's like, wait, what's going on here? So we need to help educate and communicate, you know, what's going on out here with green jobs and the opportunities that are there. Another area, I'm not gonna read through all of this here, environmental protection and preservation. Why do you guys think this would be a hot topic right now? Anyone? What's that? Greenhouse effect? Okay, okay, yeah. But consider all the damage that we've done, right, to Mother Earth. Yeah, we've done some serious damage, you know, from you know, companies that are dumping, you know, waste out into streams and, you know, onto the land. Gosh, I mean, there's so many positions tied to environmental protection. Some of those listed here. There's some shots here of workers over in Richland, Washington, that they're treating radioactive sludge. How many states have situations like this that have to be cleaned up? I mean, you can, you know, here in Long Beach, how many areas do we have where, you know, they were storing some sort of chemicals, or, you know, it leached into the water, into the land. And now they're called brownstone sites. they need to be remediated. They have to have folks that go in, you know, with all the equipment and all the protective gear to clean this stuff out. So unfortunately, this is a big area here where they're gonna need more people, okay? Here's something more positive though. Energy efficient products and manufacturing. How many of you guys have the new light bulbs in your homes or apartments or buildings? Excellent, good. Yeah, this is the future here, right? Whether it's air conditioning or solar panels or your appliances, you know, you see the Energy Star logo there, right? That's what we're trying to do, is to make all of our appliances and the other products that we use in our homes on a daily basis more energy efficient. Who's gonna do this, right? We need to have people trained. We need the manufacturing jobs to be able to create these types of products here in the United States. Yes, ma'am.
How do you guys all feel about nuclear power plants? Anybody here wanna get rid of them? If everybody in the US just change out one light bulb to a CFL light bulb, can get rid of 90 small-sized nuclear power plants. Just one CFL.
Yeah. So there's the challenge, right? There's a challenge. And I know that, you know, people have different opinions about nuclear power, but considering what we just saw over in Japan, I'd rather go this route, you know, with renewable energy. I think it's a little bit safer. I don't hear of anybody getting washed away by solar panels, right? So, all right, here's another area, recycling of existing materials. There are a couple of companies that really smart individuals. They saw these buildings being torn down and they said, wait a minute, I could reuse that. I could reuse those lights, I could reuse those windows, those doors, right? They have gotten so smart. I mean, they're recycling everything in the building. We've gone to green home tours over in Santa Monica, and I encourage you guys to do that. The U.S. Green Building Council does this every year. And I just know of the one in Santa Monica, but there's probably others that you can attend. And it is the neatest thing because these homes are made with recycled products, right? I mean, they actually put big chunks of styrofoam into their walls. What are we gonna do with that styrofoam? We don't want it to end up in the waste cycle, right? So, I mean, there's huge, they probably, what are, about 25 pounds or so? 45 pounds? Yeah. 3 feet by 2 feet. Makes the home more energy efficient, tighter, you lose less energy. Who would have thought out of styrofoam, right? So very smart individuals. So the types of jobs tied to this particular industry, deconstruction contractors, reclamation workers, recycling coordinators, recyclable material collectors. This is an actual Habitat for Humanity recycling center, right? Habitat is a really good and one of the leaders in using recycled materials as well. So and so they, you know, they have these centers. They have one over in Gardena, right off the freeway, where you can actually, as a homeowner, you can actually go in there and buy these products so that they don't end up over in our waste stream. Landfills, thank you, yeah. So very, very neat way to recycle and reuse materials. 1/3 of all of our garbage in our landfills is from construction waste. So how much can be reused and recycled, and how many jobs can be created? And still, there's only a handful of these companies out there. So another opportunity. Anyone that's interested? It's wide open. Education, compliance, and awareness, right? Marcia and I are starting a school, or trying to start a school, right? There are community colleges that are conducting the same type of workshops that we're going to be doing, same type of programs, but we're going to be offering to individuals that don't have the opportunity to go to a, you know, community or city college, you know, and spend a semester or, you know, a couple semesters there. So we'll have programs where you can do, you know, in 2-3 weeks, right? So a huge need for trainers, green consultants, curriculum designers, sustainability awareness consultants, hazardous material trainers and auditors, construction and building inspectors. All part of, you know, the whole education piece. That's an industry unto itself. I don't know how many times we started to look for a solar installer trainer. And we were told, well, you know, we don't have anyone, or we don't know of anyone, or you know what, I'm already tied to a job over at Long Beach City College, right? We can't find anyone. So we need more trainers. Now, is it going to take a little time? Yeah, because you've got to work your way, you know, as an installer and then a lead installer and so on. But once you have that background, who better than you know, to become a trainer, right? And if you like training, what a perfect job. You don't have to be up on the roof necessarily all the time, right? It's just, you know, for, you know, hands-on type training, but you end up in front of the classroom. And that's what a lot of contractors have actually done recently. There are some individuals here in Long Beach that, you know, they were struggling with their company because of the recession, and so they went into teaching, and now they are a hot commodity. They have so many jobs, they can't keep up, right? So they're doing this until the economy picks back up, and they're doing fine. So I can't stress enough that we need more people here, okay? We need more people in education. And we won't feel threatened, trust me, because again, we can't find any trainers to help us right now. So hopefully you'll come and join us, right? Each and every green industry sector will need to train existing and future subject matter experts in green-related tasks, responsibilities, technical skills, and processes. And I list just a few of them down there at the bottom, right? All of these people have to be retrained, all of them. Real estate agents. Marcia is a real estate agent, and she can tell you that. Well, you can tell them that there aren't a lot of realtors that know about green industries and green energy. And
if anybody here knows of anybody that is buying a house, there is the California Association of Realtors actually will give the new homeowner up to $250 to do an energy audit in their home. Majority of the realtors don't know about it. You know, this is a selling point for the realtor. You actually care about your buyer enough to try and save their money and live in a better, healthier, more comfortable home, and at the same time save money on their utility.
So keep that in mind. Again, you know, we were looking for a program to purchase for energy efficiency retrofitting, and we know of a few organizations out there, right? But you know, they have, you know, pretty decent programs. But my background's in training, so I figured, you know, I could probably spruce it up a little bit, right? You know, we can't get anyone long enough to sit down with us to try and create this program because they're so busy. They're so busy out there, you know, doing the training. So this is a really huge area right here, an industry that, you know, if any of you are interested, there are a lot of opportunities here. Green consultants. Every organization out there is either they are either thinking about a green consultant, or they've already hired one because they want to learn how to become green, how to become more sustainable in their organization, right? So another big area there. Sustainable and organic agriculture. So you got sustainable farming, school gardens, you know, urban agriculture. These are all things that are really hot right now. I don't know if any of you have worked in a sustainable garden here in Long Beach. There are a number of organizations that do this, right? And because they're typically nonprofits, they're looking for these types of individuals. So if this is something that you like to do, to be outside and to, you know, plant gardens and to grow sustainable and more organic food, this is an area for you, right? There are lots of volunteer opportunities here in Long Beach. You just check, you know, the local newspapers out. It was really refreshing to see Mrs. Obama out there planting with the kids, right? They were doing some organic farming out there. These are the different types of organic farming. I had no idea. I had not a clue that there were so many different ways to grow these gardens. But a home garden can yield 2 to 4 times more food per acre than any commercial agriculture. So really interesting, you know, and a potential job for you. So it's not just about solar installers. You know, these just some of the titles out there, the different positions, and you'll recognize a number of them there. Even more, right? Green facilities manager, that's going to be a huge opportunity for folks that are interested in sustainable buildings, energy efficient buildings. Who's going to continue to check on these buildings, you know, after they're certified, right? So we'll need somebody the year, you know, the following year and the year after that to go back in and recertify the buildings. So, you know, another huge area there. More examples. These are just some companies that I list here. Johnson Controls, Starwood Hotels, Maersk Lines, Verizon, Royal Caribbean, Celebrity Cruise Lines, all developing green jobs within their organizations. Yeah, who would have thought, right? Cruise lines becoming more sustainable. There's so much waste that goes on there, but they're realizing that and they're saying, you know what, we've got to do a better job. And so that's happening countrywide now. You know, Walmart has sustainability directors that are going out there and helping other companies build this position within their organization. Walmart. And unfortunately, we keep making more green jobs with things like this, with situations like this, the Gulf oil, the BP oil spill in the Gulf. You know, who's going to be cleaning up the oil and, you know, the beaches and, you know, the wildlife. This was really interesting when I read this. I'll give you guys a chance to skim through this here. Bottom line, only 60 inspectors to oversee 4,000 oil rigs. 60 inspectors. There's something wrong with that. So, you know, President Obama, the administration, various departments are looking at this and saying, we need more people tied to this area here. We can't let this happen again. So, bottom line, green collar workers in demand. It requires workers dedicated to leading this country towards a sustainable energy future. And so that's why you see the Department of Energy, Department of Transportation, Department of Labor, all of the departments now that are directing monies towards green energy, green training. Right? The top 5 green certifications, and we've talked about a few of them already. We've talked about BPI, that's the Building Performance Institute. We have over here the, hold on 1 second. That's the North American Board of Certified Electrical Practitioners. Yes. We have the Green Home Energy Raters. We have Automotive Services Certificate. And then we have the LEED, Leadership in Environmental Energy and Environmental Design. These are the top 5 green certifications right now, right? And as I mentioned earlier on, these certifications, you know, if you've got a little bit of background, they're not going to take you a lifetime to complete, right? You can go to a workshop, you can go to something that, you know, takes 2 weeks, 3 weeks, maybe a semester, and you can get, you know, the basic entry level type of certification that will get your foot in the door. And I have all of this information. Hold on 1 second. I'll be handing these out to you when we get done here. It's just a little green jobs guide. So I have all of this inside the guide here for you guys, okay? All right. I'm sorry, can't hear me? Sorry. I told you I walk around. So anyways, the five top certifications. Education is key though, right? Nearly half of all new jobs will require a post-secondary degree or education. So, you know, some type of certification, some type of a degree. And the fastest growth in new jobs will be in occupations requiring at least an associate degree. So you guys are in the right place. The top five metropolitan areas for green jobs. This is really refreshing. You notice we've got San Francisco, Oakland, San Jose, Los Angeles, Long Beach, and Riverside in the top one and two positions. We've also got San Diego, Carlsbad, San Marcos area as number seven. And then in 10 and 11 spots, we have Sacramento and San Diego. So out of those top 15 metropolitan areas, we've got about five big counties, big areas, where the green jobs are gonna continue to grow. So we're all in the right place here. Top salaries, 100,000 plus for chief sustainability officer, for environmental engineers, lawyers, environmentalists, meteorologists, renewable energy managers. We've got some more there, environmental scientists, urban planners, commercial designers, conservation scientists, and senior hydrologists. So that's where you're gonna start getting into the money there with these particular positions. So bottom line, where do you build your skills? We've already talked a little bit about this, you know, whether it's a trade school, a community college, some sort of certification type of a program that you find. These are the places that you can build these skills. Also apprenticeships with labor unions. There's a union over here in Commerce, IBEW Local 11, right? Local 11, right. And it's the electrical union. And so you can look into an apprenticeship there. If you have anyone that's in the construction trades, that's a great place to mentor, right? Because a lot of these jobs, again, are gonna be in construction, renewable energy. It's, you know, bottom line, it's up to you. You want to make a commitment to a four-year college? Here's some of the four-year colleges that are offering a number of different programs. Sustainable energy, we've got civil, environmental, and sustainable engineering, construction management, and sustainability. And more schools are starting to offer these programs. In 2005, there were only three energy and sustainability focused programs that were offered at colleges. 2010, over 100. So it's starting to grow. As I mentioned, we've been researching green jobs, green education now for the last 3 years or so, and it's amazing to see the growth here. The schools are starting to catch on. The community colleges were the ones that started this whole movement now. Now the state colleges, like Cal State Long Beach and Fullerton, they're starting to take on programs as well. So you're gonna see more and more of these programs available to all of us. Keep in mind though, if you've had any sort of lapse of education, which you guys don't have to worry about, but for friends and family that are trying to get back in here, it's gonna be a little bit of a challenge. We work with veterans, you know, who have been, you know, perhaps, you know, over in Iraq, Afghanistan, maybe their education was limited, youth at risk, women, unemployed workers, individuals that might have been out of school for, you know, 3-4 years, 10 years, right? So that's something to consider. There might be the need to, you know, perhaps go back to school, to an adult school, and get, you know, those math skills back, right? That would be number one step right there. So recognize though that this is a huge undertaking. This is a commitment that you make to, you know, to this new type of job, right? So like anything, it takes, you know, the time to study, it takes your family being supportive, it takes you just, you know, hitting the books and trying to take advantage of any type of volunteer opportunities, on the job type of training opportunities, shadowing, right? There's an organization that Marcia and I are involved with called Grid Alternatives, and they will take individuals just like you and me. They'll give you an orientation, and they will let you help with a solar installation. And so you get to see, you know, from square one, how a solar system is installed on a roof. And so we're actually going to go for our first installation in May over in Ventura. And it's a nonprofit organization, right? They work, they don't pay anybody, you know, it's just come on out and help us put this install or the system on a, you know, it's typically for low income families. But what better way to get that hands-on experience if you're in, you know, if you're studying solar installation, right? It's all through repetition, right? So a great opportunity. And there are other organizations like Grid Alternatives that provide you with these opportunities. So any chance that you have to practice, that's what we suggest. Where else do you look for jobs? Or where do you look for jobs? There's a ton of green job boards, and I have them here in the Green Job Guide. But you can just, you know, Google green job boards, right? You'll probably come up with at least, you know, 200-300 of them. And they're popping up every day, more and more of them. And they have some specific to, you know, in certain industries. There's some that are specific to jobs over in Europe and China and, you know, other parts of Asia. So really interesting to see. But you don't want to spend your entire day here, right? We don't have the time to, or the leisure to sit there and you know, just scroll through all those job boards. So instead, hold on one second. Instead, look, you know, look around you. Look in here in Long Beach. There's companies like solar installation companies, green plumbers, green roofing, green architects, contractors, sustainable gardeners, and green tech schools like ours. We'll be looking for people soon, I promise you. But these are all companies that are operating here, right here in Long Beach. Right? So if you're truly interested about getting into a green industry, start to make some phone calls. Start to, you know, visit these organizations. I know most of the people that are tied to the ones that I list here. So just let them know that I sent you over. Okay? They will be more than happy to talk to you about all the possibilities that are, you know, around that particular industry. Instead, contact industry specific staffing firms like solar, biofuels, apply for internships, volunteer on neighborhood building projects. Habitat for Humanity always has projects that they're doing. There was a couple of homes that were just built over on the west side of Long Beach. I actually got to install tile for the very first time in my life. But you know, some of those projects are now, they're going green. And so they're using green sustainable building methods to build those homes. So really neat opportunity, right? It just makes you feel good that you're part of this. Neighborhood cleanup crews, right? Let's see, research particular green industries that interest you. If you're interested in solar, then try to learn as much as you can about solar or wind or geothermal energy. Whatever it is, you need to become an expert at that because, you know, these industries are still fairly new. As I mentioned, Mercy and I have only been doing this now for about 3 years, and now people are calling us and saying, hey, can you do that workshop for us? Or hey, do you have a program on X, Y, and Z? It's, you know, 3 years. You know, I mean, I can feel it in my pocketbook because we haven't had many jobs, but we're getting those phone calls, right? We're getting those phone calls every day now. So, you know, build up your knowledge. That's you know, key. Number one, visit your local workforce investment board. They can tell you more about green jobs as well. Call me. You know, call me as well. My phone number's in here. LinkedIn. Anyone on LinkedIn yet? Okay. I encourage all of you, if you're interested in getting a green job, join LinkedIn, okay? This is something that not many people know about. There are approximately 933 renewable energy networking groups on LinkedIn. So what does that mean? There are thousands and thousands and thousands of people tied to those networking groups. And I've met a lot of people that we are now dealing with through LinkedIn. Okay, you can actually follow companies. You can search for jobs You can learn about the different positions that they have open in their companies through LinkedIn. Okay? When you join, you can request to network with, you know, all the people that are sitting here, right? You can request to network with, you know, presidents and VPs of renewable energy companies and, you know, solar energy societies. I mean, everyone is linked up on there. And you can form some great collaborations with the people that are listed there. So, just an idea. Again, instead of sitting and looking at all the green job boards, join green networks. Start your own sustainability club. You know, even youth groups that are starting out there. If you have kids that are interested in you know, renewable energy and sustainability, there's a program or an organization called Empowering Youth to Cool the Earth. And it's a kid that, he was 13 years old when he saw Al Gore's movie, An Inconvenient Truth. And he wrote to Al Gore and said, I want to go around the world and teach people about climate change. And Al Gore and his people said, you're a little bit too young, you know, call back in a couple years, right? And so he created his own movement. And we just saw him over at a school. What was the school? I can't remember. Citrus College, yeah. And he did a presentation for about 500 kids that day. They bussed in a bunch of kids from the elementary schools. They had kids, folks from the college there, old folks like us. And he was so inspiring. Oh my God, we were in tears because he talked about, you know, he started when he was 13. He's 16 years old now. He's been around the world. He's been to the UN. He's been to Copenhagen. He went for the climate change summit there and he spoke there in front of, you know, thousands of people. He started his own group. Right? So these are things that you can do as well, or your kids can do. You know, it's all about, you know, the education. It's all about communicating the importance of you know, green jobs, about sustainability and becoming more energy efficient. But with all of this, update your resume. Right? You guys know this. Anytime you volunteer, anytime you join something, make sure that that's included on the resume, because that's what employers are looking for right now. They're looking for individuals that, you know what, maybe they didn't have a job, but they volunteered at two or three different organizations and they got that experience. They volunteered at Grid Alternatives. They volunteered for a group like Green Long Beach, for example. Whatever it was, it's gonna add up. It's gonna add up on your resume, right? And an employer's gonna look at that and say, hey, this is the type of person that I want to join my organization. So it's all important. Invest, determine what jobs are growing, what qualifications are required, sign up for industry newsletters. I probably get about 15 to 20 different newsletters from various sustainable energy organizations, and there's always something there that helps Marcia and I with our business. Every day, there's, you know, a different newsletter that comes in, and we'll find out about a new project, or we'll find out about a new hot job. So trust me, those newsletters, yeah, it gets a little tiresome scrolling through your emails, but they've got a lot of really good information if you're serious about getting a green job. Okay, bottom line, get your foot in the door. You have to prepare. You have to do all of these things that we've just been talking about. You know, get really smart about the different industries, and especially the one that you want to enter, right? Introduce yourself via LinkedIn. Introduce yourself to someone from the company. Tell them that you want to work for that company. That's how people are getting in the door these days, right? Last but not least, get involved. Anyone heard of armchair politics? It's, you know, when, you know, you get those requests from various groups and they say, sign this petition. Well, you know what? It really works. If enough of us sign those petitions, then our Congress people and senators have to go back and say, wait a minute, I got 50,000 letters and 50,000 emails, you know, talking about how they want more funding for green jobs. That's how we make change happen, right? So, you know, write letters, send those emails, become an advocate for a new green economy. And here's some of the groups that I mentioned, I might have mentioned earlier on: Repower America, Green for All, Apollo Alliance, Blue Green Alliance, Operation Free. Green Long Beach is a local organization here. rebuild the United States, all organizations that are fighting for green jobs, right? Anyone heard of Operation Free? This is a group, please look this up. This is a group of veterans, military personnel, that have come back from Iraq, Afghanistan, maybe they served in Vietnam, and they formed this coalition across the United States, and they're saying very loudly, we need to get, you know, to just get away from our oil dependence, you know, and you know, that dependence on oil from the Middle East. They're talking about our safety. They're talking about climate change. You know, they're talking about, you know, that we need to create renewable energy here in the United States. This is the military, former military personnel that are going around the country talking about this. So look that one up, Operation Free. If any of you guys are veterans, I encourage you to join that one if you're if you're really interested in green jobs. You know, support their efforts, you know, write to lobby Congress, the president. That's how we, again, how we make this happen, how we create more green jobs here. And let me, you know, we're near the end here. Let me ask all of you, if you were a green employer, right, you had your own green company tomorrow, what would you want from your employees? What would you expect from that employee that you're hiring? Yes, ma'am.
Belief
in the product, okay. Belief in the product, yes.
A willingness to continue your education.
Say that one more time.
A willingness to continue your education.
Okay, a willingness to continue their education. Okay, anything else? Well, you know what? We've talked to tons of employers out there, right? And in preparation for our conducting, you know, the various programs that we're going to be delivering, we've asked employers, what is it that you want from your next employee? And these were some of the things that they came up with. A trailblazer, they're not afraid of ambiguity and wearing a few hats, right? Because these businesses are so new, you know, you might be hired as a sales rep, but you might be doing, you know, some other sort of marketing and admin as well, right? You might have been hired as an installer, but you might have to also sub as a sales rep and start to learn about design, right? Two different functions, right? So someone that isn't afraid of wearing more than one hat, right? Someone that learns on the fly, they thrive on learning. Again, new industries, new businesses, they need you to be gung-ho, to get in there and say, hey, show me what you got. Show me, you know, about my job, but show me about that other person's job too, right? Shines in sales and service situations, provides exemplary service. Again, they're just starting out. They're trying to make a name for themselves. They need workers, employees that are committed to providing that exemplary service. Mature, able to work in challenging, ever-changing markets and environments. Right? Demonstrate the values of the organization. And I think someone kind of alluded to that. Sustainable practices, ethical dealings, integrity, empathy, and you know, whenever you're interacting with customers and clients. Motivated to make the world a better place. You have core green values. And I always talk about this when we're doing this workshop with kids especially. I said, you know, think about the impression that someone's gonna get from you walking up to their doorstep, right? I'm the green company and I'm gonna be hiring you, and I see you get off your truck out there and you're smoking a cigarette, or you got a cup of coffee and you toss the coffee cup down and you toss your cigarette butt down. What type of impression am I gonna get from this potential employee? Maybe not a favorable one, right? And these are things that sometimes they don't think of, right? So you have to kind of keep that in mind. Do you have the same green values, the same sustainable values? If you don't, better do a check before you get to the door, right? Think about that one. So really important. You know, another area, start your own company, right? We're starting a green tech school. You can start your own whatever, right? You know, healthy local food, green transportation, green product innovation, green home and office cleaning services, energy efficient home, green home retrofit company, green landscaping, green plumbing. How many green plumbers are there here in Long Beach? Two. Do you know that there's a huge push to create these gray water systems in the city now? Anyone know what a gray water system is? Basically, it takes the water. Help me out. Yes, exactly. Yeah, good answer. So basically she was saying that it's water that is not necessarily suitable for drinking again, but it's recycled so that it can be used on your lawns and, you know, for washing your clothes, right? That sort of thing. So, you know, the gray water technicians, we need to have more of those individuals trained and ready to work, because there's going to be a huge project here in Long Beach, right? And more cities are taking a look at that. Because why? Because we're running out of water. There's a water shortage, right? So, you know, we need to find ways to become more water efficient and be able to recycle that water for other uses. So again, start your own company, right? There's all sorts of industries that need you as an employee, but why not become part of that industry as your own company, right? So bottom line, get your foot in the door. We talked about different ways to do that. Keep focused, keep motivated, keep practicing, and don't give up. Keep learning. Bottom line, keep learning. There's my contact information here. We really appreciate your time today. It's probably a little bit earlier than we planned, right? But I'll take questions, and if you guys want to talk to us a little bit more. Yes, absolutely.
Who here knows of anybody that's been hit with this economy? Yeah. Can you even imagine somebody that have been only working with a company 1 year and actually have the guts to quit if they don't get their 20% increase? Can anybody imagine that? Yeah? You think that's happening today? What do you think? It is. Stella was invited or asked to help out a company who has, it's a lead project management company. It's a very small company. They have approximately 4 to 6 employees. And most of those employees are threatening to walk and quit because there's headhunters asking them to go to another organization. Imagine that, their lead AP project managers. So if anybody here is thinking about lead projects, getting their lead AP certifications, do so, because there are so many jobs out there for that. Okay.
So, yeah, good point. I mean, you know, it's a changing economy now, especially with green industries. There's a lot of opportunities. There's different ways to go about getting into these fields, different types of education paths that you can take. Please, you know, talk to us more about it after the workshop. I think I might have like maybe one more slide or a couple more slides. Please do your part, right? Each and every one of us try to reuse, recycle, right? Reduce our waste. That's critical. And that will also help to create jobs as well. Learn more about these industries, right? And what you can do both at home and at work to help create a more sustainable environment. You know, like average worker uses 10,000 sheets of copy paper each year. You know, can we cut that down to 5,000? Perhaps, right? Yeah. So, you know, lots of other facts and figures that we could share with you. We don't have enough time here. Try not to greenwash. If you go into business, you know, for yourself, anyone know what greenwashing means? There was a really cute little ad for Hooters, and they had like a green label underneath, and someone said, well, what the heck's green about Hooters, right? We were all looking at the ad and we're trying to figure out what about this ad is green, or what about their service or their food is green. We couldn't figure it out. We all sat there, you know, just kind of looking at the ad. That's what greenwashing means. So, you know, make sure that, you know, you're talking about sustainable practices, energy efficient practices. That's what, you know, what this movement is all about. It's not just putting a green label on your company or on your product and saying that it's green, right? Bottom line, the pictures provided by Google Images, and I really appreciate the time that you spent with us today. This program was made possible by a grant that we received from Connected Corridor and from the James L. Knight Foundation. And so I really appreciate your time. You will each get one of these green guides, and it has some of the information that was covered today. So thank you guys all for your time.